Learn about access control for Azure Synapse Analytics this week on Data Exposed MVP Edition. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed MVP Edition. Today, I'm joined by Heini, MVP. And Heini, why don't you kick us off by telling us a little bit about yourself and what you do?
Yeah. Hi, Anna. Thank you so much for having me. I work as a DevOps consultant, so I actually work in software development projects, but also on the data side of things, so sometimes also in data platform solutions, but I really focus on the DevOps side and really making infrastructure side of things easy. And that's kind of also where this particular topic came up, how to handle access control in Synapse.
Awesome. Well, it's exciting to have you on the show. And I know we're going to be talking about access control. And Azure AD is something we talk about a decent bit on the show, but not as relates to Synapse. So I'm really looking forward to learning from you, and I think our viewers will too. So why don't we get right into it? Can you tell us a little bit about some of the considerations when it comes to access control for things like Synapse?
Yeah, so really if we think about Synapse as a whole, it's more like a collection of services and capabilities brought together. So it also shows up on the access control side and can make things a little bit, not complicated, but there's more things to consider, I'd say. But Azure AD on the background is kind of helping us make that as smooth as possible for us, that experience, and really use those identities efficiently.
Gotcha. Cool. So how does it work?
All right. Let's look at a bit of a sketch to first figure out kind of the overview of how everything works. So as I mentioned, Azure Synapse Analytics is more a collection of things. So when you set it up, you, for example, require an Azure data lake. You then also have the serverless SQL pool to use from the very beginning. And then in addition to that, you can, of course, then create a dedicated SQL pool. Also, you can use the Spark pools as well. And then you also have the pipelines capability available as well. So there are many of these different capabilities built into Synapse Analytics. And when you're creating this analytics workspace, what you're going to be using is your identity. And what you might not be thinking of is that this identity is actually in Azure AD. And really, Azure AD is a place for an organization's different identities to be gathered in one place so that you can use them across Azure and actually across all the different Microsoft cloud services in general. So it's not only restricted to Azure. But what you have here is, of course, your users and groups, and also applications and devices as well. But that is not so much what we will be talking about today. So we'll mainly focus on the users and groups that are kind of stored and handled in Azure AD in a central way. So then when you have these identities in Azure AD, then you're able to leverage these identities to assign the appropriate kind of access. And with Azure Synapse Analytics, there are a few layers that we need to consider. So for example, from the very beginning that you're able to create an Azure Synapse Analytics workspace, you need to have adequate Azure RBAC permissions. Then when we get into Azure Synapse Analytics, then within there we have Synapse roles. But these Synapse roles are mainly about managing the workspace. So we are able to give access to creating pipelines, authoring notebooks and scripts, etc. But it doesn't actually give you access to the data layer itself. So that is one really important thing to know, that you do actually need to manage that separately and put thought into it, like what data does this user require access for? So that means that also on the SQL side, when we create databases, et cetera, we need to go in there and give the required SQL roles to the users that we want to use. And on the other hand, when we use Azure Data Lake Storage, we can again leverage Azure RBAC roles to give those users the required access that they need. So you can see there's like four of these different layers of access control and permissions that we need to keep in mind when we think about Synapse Analytics.
Gotcha. But, and this seems pretty similar to how Azure SQL Database works as well. You have these ideas of your Azure RBAC rules for kind of managing, but then you also need access to the actual data.
Exactly. And the idea is exactly the same. And even the role and identity creation within, for example, the serverless SQL pool is pretty much the same as in Azure SQL. And we'll take a look at that in practice in a moment. So that's kind of the overview. And now that we have that, we can go in and look a little bit more on the hands-on side of things. How do you really work with this? So I have already created beforehand a Synapse Analytics workspace so that we can look at those aspects that we want to kind of check out here. And so the access control side you can find from the manage lane here in Synapse Analytics workspace when you come here. And you will see the user that you used to create this Synapse Analytics workspace. For me, it's this very first person in this list. And then I also added later on another user that has the access. The one thing to note about these Synapse administrators is that they get automatic access to the serverless SQL pools and also the dedicated SQL pools to run queries there and add access to other users as well. So that makes it a little easier to manage that these administrators get the access right off the bat. But it is good to note that for Azure Data Lake storage, you do need to do that separately. So it's not like automatically propagated at this point. And let's hope that in the future, some of those capabilities get actually built in and some of those things happen automatically as well. So pretty much we need to determine when we're kind of setting up the access in the right way is that what kind of capabilities does a user need? So then, for example, if we decide that, well, we need to create a SQL serverless database, which I have created here, and then I want to get into having access in there, I can use the user that I used to create this Azure Synapse workspace in the beginning, and I can log in and run my queries over here, or I can also use Management Studio if I'm more comfortable working there, and I have my scripts ready here, so we can use this as well and connect to the serverless pool from there as well. And I can just create a login for the user that I want to use. This is just a user that I made up a few moments ago before this. So I will just run this query here. So we're going to create a login, which needs to be created at the master database level. And then I will then create a user based on that login and then give it DB owner role. I could, of course, give a reader role or whatever the role is that is required for this particular user. So after I have that done that, then this particular user will have access to this new database that I created here within my serverless SQL database that I set up. But I do need to go separately and give the specific access that that user requires. It doesn't get kind of automatically pulled in, even if I would give them some kind of Synapse roles itself. So
gotcha.
That's it.
Awesome. This is really cool. And again, what I love about this is it's almost like exactly what you would do for, say, Azure SQL Database or Azure SQL Managed Instance. You use these Azure RBAC roles to do some of the managing side of things. And then from SQL itself is where you're going to do things like manage your logins, manage your users using T-SQL languages a lot of people are really familiar with. Exactly. In this whole process, like as you've learned about this and as you work with folks on this, do you have any tips or tricks as people get started or advice?
Yeah, the one thing I would kind of think about from the very beginning is set up your groups. So you're probably going to have some users that are in similar roles. So it is more efficient to do the access control management if you have those users in one group, then you just assign the group itself to the specific role that you desire, and then you're all set. Then you just can move the users in and out of the groups and they automatically have the correct access. You don't have to go to all the three different places to give the different levels of access to the data lake and to Synapse itself, et cetera, to get it all working the right way. So that would be my kind of number one trick to start with.
Thanks, Heini. That makes a lot of sense. You know, in these types of situations, groups are going to be your friend. I learned a lot during this episode, and I think our viewers probably did too. So thanks so much for coming on the show. To our viewers, if you like this episode, go ahead and give it a like, comment, and let us know how you're using Azure AD and Synapse Analytics. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.